to fire what?
Going back home? Not home, but what's going back to playing against Chicago.
Yeah.
What are the thoughts that come to you?
You know, for me, it's not about that. It really isn't. People say that, but this is a year and a half away from my time there. But being back home here with these guys, and we know what we have ahead of us, being able to prepare for any NFL game in particular, like you just said, you know, it's I know people in the building, I know players, a lot of support staff, and you know that's what's real. But at the same point in time, you really do try to get to a point where you want to make sure that it's not about any of that, and I mean that. You know, this is about our team versus them, and me being a Kansas City Chief and going out and being better from last week. You know, regardless of who we're playing, we got to improve offensively, be better there, and that's really been the focus since that game ended last weekend.
Is that as easy as you just made it sound?
What's that?
Just to focus just purely on that stuff.
Yeah, it is.
Consider the fact that you're playing Chicago.
It is. I mean, we got to probably more than anything for me was more of even in the preseason last year, going back to Chicago, a lot of familiar faces, people. So I feel like I got that out of the way last year. And now here we are a year and a half later. And, you know, it's a different team there now. There's still some players that I know. I built some unbelievable relationships with people in the building. Very appreciative of the relationships I built with George McCaskey, Mrs. McCaskey, Ted Phillips, Ryan Pace, et cetera. A lot of players and coaches, but that's in the past, you know. And so right now I'm so excited to be in here with these guys and practicing every day and making what you just asked me simple so that we can go and do everything we can to get a win, for real.
Matt, what are the coaching points with Juwan this week?
Well, again, we talked week one about some of the drops with the wideouts, emphasizing it, but yet not making it such a huge deal to where it impacts them again this week. And Juwan is a really, really good football player. He's a great person. He wants to be better. And so the only thing you can possibly do is just continue to just keep practicing with the cadence, whether it's verbal or nonverbal, which we are more nonverbal there in Jacksonville. So just keep working on it. And if there's times in practice where it happens, why did it happen and how do we fix it? And we know that, you know, officials and other teams are looking for it. He knows that. We know that. So we just got to keep working at it. That's the only thing you can do.
He's had an issue in his career, obviously, when he was with Jacksonville. How much have you had to work with him up to this point about those kinds of things?
Yeah, Coach Heck's done a great job of being able to probably emphasize and just remind him at times, you know, when you mix the cadence up verbally, too. It's one thing when you go on one every play. It's another thing when you now change it up and you go on two, on three, et cetera, change your cadence up. So that's even more of a challenge. So staying positive with it, I think for sure, and Juwan knows this, you know, it wasn't just him. Now, those false start penalties last week affected us and put us in second and longs. But we had a lot of other penalties. We had a lot of other self-inflicted errors that we have to be better at. In all phases, you know what I mean? So we look at that. We always start with us as coaches, like how can we put guys in best positions possible? And then when we do, how are you executing? And part of that is pre-snap, is making sure there's no, you know, false start penalties, illegal formations, et cetera. We had all of that last week. We had turnovers, but we also, as bad as it was, we won the football game because of great defense. And situational football offensively last week. You know, end of the half, we score a touchdown. Start of the third quarter, we go down and have a nice drive. And then to end the game, we're in a four-minute mode. We have a big play, third and whatever, six, make a big play, and then finish it with the ball. So situationally, that's the good. But we gotta be better so that we can help our defense and special teams to be all three phases.
When you're able to start the second half with a 30-yard run and kind of stick and the run's working, how does that help your offense in totality?
Well, it's big. Any big plays, explosives, when you have a big, especially in the run game, that's an easy breather for the quarterback. It's a great momentum builder for the O-line. It sets the defense because now play action's better because you're running it. So, and then when you do it the first play of the third quarter, that's momentum, you know, as far as being able to just get going and get points. And so that was great. But too many drives last week where we were going backwards. And we're way too detailed and we're way too, you know, hard on ourselves in regards to making sure that coaches and players are on the same page with doing everything the right way and not beating ourselves. And Jacksonville's that's a great defense and a great team. But it just goes to show, in the end, when you play like that, we still won the game. Now, what can we do when we don't do that has been kind of where we're at this week.
Matt, when you hit with young quarterbacks, and I'm not asking about Justin Fields, because he said what he said yesterday about having too many things in his head, but you've been around a lot of young quarterbacks. Mm-hmm. How do you find the balance as a coordinator or a head coach to get them not to be thinking too much and get them to play freely?
Yeah, there's a lot that goes into the answer to that question. I'll say, just for sake of time, that, you know, we live in this world of instant gratification right now. I'll start there. And so wherever we are, you see a lot of these young quarterbacks that come in that are forced to play and do well right away. You have the old stories of other quarterbacks 5, 10, 15 years ago, even some more recently, that have had some time to sit and get to see. These NFL defenses are so much different than college. And so you need to, you know, be able to adjust and adapt to the player and how they can grow. But you also got to be able to go through the highs and the lows together. And so, to your point, I mean, it's in this league. It's not just Justin in Chicago. It's in this league in general. How do you do that, navigate through that, and staying together, staying positive, and going through that with Patrick as a rookie, letting him see Alex, living that, and then my experiences in Chicago with Mitchell. And, you know, there's a lot to it. But, yeah, I think staying together, being positive, but also understanding that instant gratification is real. So how do you get to that point?
Bouncing off the run game.
You're good.
It seems that kind of more slanted towards passing for the first few games. Just, is that a concerted effort, or is there a calculation before you go into a game?
Well, every game you always have an idea of what you think you want to do, and then you get in the game, you got to adjust to what's working and what's not working. But I think, you know, Coach Reed does such a great job since the day he started coaching of being able to really formulate how we want to win, start off that way, and then personnel-wise and whatever it is schematically. And if the run game's going, then we'll go ahead and get to that. If the pass game is going, it just so happens there's been a few more passes recently. I think if you know Coach Reed, it probably doesn't shock you, but that's who we are, and we want to be able to be balanced, and we got great players to be able to do both.
Well, and along those exact lines, I mean, against Jacksonville, first half you have 26 plays, 2 designed runs, 24 passes.
Sure.
Obviously that's more out of balance than you usually are. Do you get in the point of the game in a situation like that where you're looking like, okay, wait a minute, maybe we're not doing what we want to do here?
Well, I ran into this question before because those numbers happen, and sometimes in these offenses with RPOs, you might have a run called and the ball gets thrown, and so there might be some more run calls that are in the play calling, and so that's always one that jumps out to me when you have a glaring stat like that. But at the same point in time, to your referral, you want to do whatever you can do to get yards, and so if it is running and it's working, then you're going to go ahead and call more runs naturally, set it up with play actions and screens. But if it's throwing too, you know, we got a pretty good quarterback and we want the ball in his hands as well. So I don't think any of that was intentionally to really answer your question. None of it was intentional. I think it's just kind of a little bit of a flow. And when you look back at those first, what was it, 5 series in the first half, 4 of them weren't very good. So you just try to get a rhythm. There was no rhythm for us really in that game offensively. So we got to get back to getting rhythm, and whether that is running the football or whatever, we got to just figure out a way to do that as coaches and players, and I think we will.
Last one, Nick.
Yeah, Matt, I know you've been able to venture out on a couple Friday nights and kind of take the game in as a fan. What's that been like for you, and do you kind of catch yourself sometimes being like the down distance coordinator mindset?
Yeah, probably way too much. My wife has to chill me out. I love it because it's my 4 boys, and all these times growing up, all these little youth baseball games, football, basketball, and now it's like, you know, it's high school, it really counts, you know. So it's been fun, but without a doubt, I gotta just go up in the top corner, stay away, and just drink have some sunflower seeds and coffee and just shut up and let them go play and go win, you know. So that's it. But it's fun, and his coaching staff has been phenomenal. They're great guys, and they do a great job.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you. See you.